Welcome back to another Only Frames production featuring the Ramsgate Rail Pool League, the only OF subscription where two guys running around with their cues won't cost you your marriage or half of your pension. Today's game features Lou the Dog Saraf versus Chris the Dumpton Destroyer. Chris currently sitting top of the league standings versus Louis, who some would say at the other end of proceedings currently, but that can be turned around pretty quickly. This is an exhibition game for a few pennies. Please gamble responsibly. This is a first to 10, best of four sets, Louis getting an 8-0 head start each set. He only needs to win two frames per set, while Chris needs to take down 10. Chris is up against it here, but he looks like he could have an early opportunity to take the deficit down to 7. Red over the hole, and well, maybe this guy is human. We haven't seen many misses like that this season so far from Chris. He'll be disappointed with that, but it's early doors, and no doubt he'll get another 36 opportunities in this frame alone. Louis down the lens, bottom right pocket, center of the hole. All of a sudden, Lou has got an opportunity, but he's going to need to play a good positional shot here. Maybe off the one cushion, try and leave that yellow into the top left pocket. Bit of screw needed. No screw whatsoever. It hit the right-hand rail cushion with stun, and he's come the wrong side of the yellow. Maybe just a case of bumping out this red to steal the pocket. That's what he's tried to do. Not quite left it how he would have wanted, but he's pretty safe from there. Chris hasn't got the easiest of pots here. May play a little safety shot himself to just try and get back to the table with the balls in a slightly better position. Attempt at a snooker potentially along the way as well. Hasn't quite got it. Louis can see the edge. Long pot here for Louis to take a commanding 9-0 lead with the black in a good position, and he hammers it home. Call this man 4. Red, get out of the way. It has got out of the way, leaving Louis the simplest of chances to take a 9-0 lead. It's 9. On to the second frame we go, with Chris at the table playing yellows. First ball nicely cemented into the heart of the middle pocket, taking this yellow up the rail, trying to... Not too sure what he's trying to do there. I'm not sure he even knows. Maybe come a bit further across to leave a better angle on this yellow. This is going to prove difficult from here. That was a difficult shot because it was hard to get nicely onto this yellow. He has got a shot into the middle by the looks of it, but this isn't easy, that's for sure. Especially with the black being where it is. Maybe he can play to try and knock it off the red next to the black to develop the black along the way, but I'm not sure if he can quite see the angle for that. He's played the double, and that's found the jaws. All of a sudden, this is an opportunity for Louis to take this first set 10-0. That would be embarrassing. A hammering. Come on, Louis. You can do it, my boy. First one. I think he's tried to stun that, and he's run it through, leaving a slightly hampered white ball. In pool, you want to give yourself the best opportunities at all time, and by doing that, it's staying away from dangers like this unnecessarily. Now, red to the top right pocket. No good. Nope, that's not good, Q, and he'll be disappointed with that. That was an opportunity. He'd actually played a decent positional shot. Could have taken that top red, which was his last difficult ball, and the clearance would have been on. Now Chris with the easiest of opportunities to finally get a mark up on the board. Yellow, safely dispatched. Now onto the bat. This guy doesn't miss these. He's still alive in this. 9-1. Onto the third frame of the set, and that's a KFC shot there from Louis with the chicken wing coming out whilst queuing through the ball there. He'll be disappointed with that, but we can't be having any more mistakes from Chris here. He knows with only one frame to play with, he can't be making any simple or basic errors. When opportunities present themselves, he needs to take them. Where's the cue ball going? Wowzers, this is a massive chance for Louis to wrap this first set up and get that £5 halfway into his pocket. First ball down the cushion. Lovely. Although it's wiped its feet, it was pretty safe. It was at a good pace. The lighter you hit them, if they hit their knuckles, they do have more chance of dropping in. He's absolutely larruped that one into the hole. Not sure he needed to. Maybe that was for the cameras. This man is a showman. Call him Hugh Jackman. But we have more twists and turns in this set. Not only has he missed it, he's also found the snooker. One cushion escape here from Chris, though. He might even pot this if he hits it. And he has! But that isn't ideal, believe it or not, ladies and gentlemen. Now he's got to come up with something for this black. What's he going to do? Roll it off the cushion snooker? That is woeful, pitiful, absolutely useless, man. Louis, how'd you like money? Even I fancy potting this. Jesus, this is for 10-1 and the set. The crowd are on the pitch. It's 10-1. On to set two we go, and Louis at the table with a one set lead, and once again an 8-frame head start. That was a lovely angle on that yellow to develop his tricky balls, but he's forgot to pot it. That was over the hole, but he has got second prize and left Chris stitched. Going to attempt the swerve shot. And like Philip Schofield on a grooming charge, he's managed to swerve that perfectly. But he could not find position on the black. I think this is going to be off the side cushion, in behind it. And I hope to pop this ball anywhere. Middle pocket. Unlucky. Nice attempt there from Chris. Very nice indeed. Louis back to the table with all seven yellows still remaining on. I, for one, am hoping he don't pot any, because I'd love to see him run around the table with his pants down, but he has got one, much to the crowd's disappointment. Boo hoo. Still six on, and once again, this guy does not worry about position. He'll pot them off the lampshades if he needs to. Taking the yellow down the rail, no good, rattle once again. But has he got second prize once more? This guy is walking a fine tightrope. Can Chris see it? Time will tell. He could see it, but he couldn't pot it. Nicely brought into play by Christo, leaving himself the opportunity, shall it arise, and he gets another visit to the table. Louis taking on to the top left pocket. Nicely dispatched from the dog. Once again, though, not found himself perfectly on the ball. Going to have to take this one down the bottom. Currently sat over the hole to keep this visit going. Cues up. Lovely hair, this guy. Could be in one of the L'Oreal adverts in the future. You never know. And I don't know what's happened, but we've skipped to the end of the frame. And Chris is rolling in, making it 8-1. Answers on a postcard for what happened at the end of that frame. I'm unsure, but we know it's 8-1. But here is the opportunity for Louis to make it 9. Once again, I think he'll be disappointed with that position. Just needs to think a bit more. Use your brain, man. But still, a shot. A shot for immortality. To go 9-1 in the lead. Tricky, but this man can do it. And he's managed to double hit it. That is awful. Terrible. Chance for Chris. Lovely struck into the middle. Mind you, this isn't the easiest of positional shots. Going to have to go off that top cushion. It's all about the pace here. All about the pace. That is abysmal. Shocking. Woeful. Pathetic. My vocabulary isn't large enough to describe how bad that shot was. Does this man not like money? He is being more than kind to Louis so far today, and not being as clinical as he usually is. What's he got up his sleeve here, though? Could he play a little nudge off to create a snooker? No, he's just played safe, trying to leave that white in close behind the back. Nobody knows what's happening here, but Louis taking it up to the top right-hand pocket. I don't know if it's in yet. I'm going to find out any moment now. Isn't it? No, it can't be. He shook his head. And as usual, has potted the white ball. Chris now, two simple balls. Good setup that. Now just the left into the bottom right, black into the bottom left. I'm getting confused with all these left and rights. But in a moment's time, it will be 8-2 and game on. 8-2. Onto the third frame of the set we go. Chris currently 2-0 up in the set, but Louis with a 8-0 head start. And that, ladies and gentlemen, is a hit and a miss. Chris playing for the fine edge and completely missed the ball. But Louis, the kindest man we all know, has repaid the favour in kind. Louis is honestly such a nice guy. He recently gave up his seat to a VIP. And that's how he lost his job as a train driver. I thank you. Back to the action we go with Chris missing a gimme of a chance. These are meant to be the highlights, gentlemen, and this is what I'm seeing. This kind of content makes Mrs. Brown's boys look decent. And that is the worst thing my eyes have ever seen in my life. But now, Chris here, surely he can make it 8-3. He isn't playing great so far today, but we know this guy is a very capable player. Two balls left to contend with. You'd assume just a roll in here, leave a relatively straightforward black. Nicely done there, Chris. Always thinking this guy. Just giving himself that extra bit of angle by moving the red slightly away from the white ball just to save any hampered cueing. That is top pool IQ right there. And for the first time today, he's found the heart of the hole. Unfortunately, the next four frames were lost due to battery issues. What is going on? Chris has changed. We're on a different table, different lighting. Come on, this is a professional organisation we're meant to be running here. This is a different day. I'm not having it. I know this is not camera magic. These guys, they are taking the mickey. But I can only commentate on what is put in front of me. It's now 8-7. It still remains a race to 10. And we have Louis at the table, who is sporting some kind of superhero t-shirt. Or maybe that's just my picture across his chest. Chris now to the table, wearing orange, or could be red. I'm not too sure. But he is playing reds, we know that. The Denim Destroyer, this guy's favourite girl band, are Bewitched. That is an interesting stat about Chris there. And he's playing the cross double, and he nails it. Good shot, and this is a frame-winning opportunity all of a sudden. It didn't look like it when he came to the table, but with a little bit of magic and a good pot there, he has opened up and could draw level, which is never good news when you have an 8-0 head start. Louis, hang your head in shame. Now, two balls, one of them over the hole. This is all about position. He could cannon into this yellow. It could prove problematic for him. Yeah, that was always going to be the tricky part of the shot there, but he had fancy putting this black into the bottom left pocket. Fine edge. Got to watch the white ball. There's a danger. White ball safe. And the black is safely sent home. 8-all. If my maths is correct, and I think it is, we're now on to the ninth frame. Louis, I'm sure, is feeling the same colour as his outfit, slightly grey inside. But all the time he's at the table, things are in his control, and all of a sudden, this guy looks like he's found a bit of form. Gonna take the red to the middle pocket here. Ideally, we'd like to leave an angle to get on or to move what's going to be the final red, the one in between the two yellows. He's not quite got the angle he would have wanted. Might need to roll this in and take a long red, and he slapped it. What a fluke artist. Jaffa, lovely jubbly, and here's a chance to go back in front when all not so long ago seemed lost. The tricky part of this is going to be getting on the black, as the two yellows are causing havoc. But he rolls ahead nicely, and he is perfect on this black. Deep breath, cues back, rolls it, finds the hole. 9-8, 9-8. Come on, the dog, do it for the underdogs. We join the action once again with Louis putting his cue in the air and finding absolutely no swerve whatsoever. That is a foul. Chris has ball in hand. Even if he did make contact on the way back through after he'd missed the swerve shot, as no balls hit the cushion after contact with the cue ball, that is a foul in the rules we are currently playing. Chris to take one down the corner. He's blasted it. Unlucky! Can he see the edge though? All of a sudden, when Chris has it put up him, he isn't as comfortable. Maybe some of us need to take that into the league and realise under pressure, he is an absolute melt. He's an ice cream in the desert, folding like a deck chair under pressure. But he's managed to send that red towards the hole. Louis back to the table under real pressure here. Can't afford to make a mistake in this frame if he wants to see the set off at this visit. First ball, yellow over the hole off the top cushion. Get out the way, man. We're trying to view the action. As usual, his positional play has left a lot to be desired. He's going to have to pull a pot out of one of his orifices if he wants this visit to remain, or is he going to find a snooker from somewhere? Taking his yellow top right-hand pocket by the looks of things. And that was closer to the middle pocket. Awful, woeful, 1 out of 10. Chris now, red over the hole. Simple positional shot off that bottom cushion. Get onto this black. Make it 9 apiece and a one-frame shootout. This is what the crowd want to see. Here we go. He's got it. It's 9-all. And this is the decider. I am shaking like a dog crapping. I wonder how the players are feeling in this cauldron of pressure. That was a good pot by Louis. He is snookered, and that was all caused by himself. After about 15 minutes of working out the angles, he's going to play one cushion, bit aside, no side. Miss. That's a shot and a visit. Could that be his final visit of the set? Only time will tell. Chris at the table now. 5 yellows remain between him and victory. Chris has shown nerves throughout today's performance. Is he going to find his A game at the crucial time? Back in his day, he would have fancied this all day long. He would have eaten this for breakfast. Now he probably eats something boring like porridge. He probably doesn't even have sugar. 3 yellows remain. That is a very nice positional shot. He's actually left the choice of two. He's going to take this one yellow to the right of the two, leaving one to the middle, one to the top left, and the black down to the bottom right. This is pressure, ladies and gentlemen. Will his nerves suffice? Rolls in, no chances taken. Now, bit of bottom left, I'm sure, to get nice and close to the black. Not really got into that. Would have liked to have been a bit closer to it. But still, it's a shot to draw things level. And it rattles, but it has dropped. The gravity is on. That is one set apiece.